Good evening, dear colleagues. Thank you. For those who are left, I'll try to have it all in 10 minutes. May I have a presentation? Talking about combined treatment of NSCLC, I think that the volume of combined treatment is insufficient in our country, and there are few reasons. So out-of-date device for radiotherapy and chemical and radiotherapy is carried out in different institutions, fear to toxicity and absence of contact between radiotherapeutists and chemotherapeutists. In our center, we've got all the possibilities to carry on all the procedures, but we have very few patients. But we are the private center, and the cost is quite high, and not all of them can allow themselves to pay for it. But there are a few moments of this combined treatment. This patient with squamous cell cancer, so he's got left lung cancer with masses and lots of tissue is damaged, and the task is quite complicated for radiotherapeutists. But we've got the opportunity to apply all the modern methods. That are available nowadays we picked up quite an aggressive option with so 66 grain in dose of 2 and 6 grain to damaged lymph nodes and 54 grains to the healthy lymph nodes weekly, and 2 maintaining cycles once per 3 weeks. And I want to say a few words about high doses. You know that the results of the research published in 2013. So the patients were divided into 2 groups. In one, it was 60 GU, 74 in the second, and chemotherapy was standard. And they wanted to show that higher doses show high efficiency, but the result was vice versa. Survival rate was lower in high dose patients due to high toxicity and severe cardiopathologies and lethal effects. And the president of the Congress stated that obviously escalation on patients of NSCLC, the photon therapy cannot give us higher and safer results. But nevertheless, our case, the doses were higher, and what we want to say a few words about. So you can see pneumonitis, it was one of the side effects. It was in both lungs. It was completely compliable with this 25 grades. So this is the limit that says that there is a big chance of development of this radiopneumonitis. What I want to note, this patient was followed up within the radiochemistry course, and we followed up after the therapy, and with the symptoms of pneumonitis, not only us, but also pneumonologist, and it allowed us to give good effect. You can see the to compare CTs in 4 and in 18 months, so almost no signs of pneumonitis, and the clinical symptoms completely disappeared, and 18 months later, the patient feels okay with good clinical effect. What is also important in planning combined treatment, how we define the volume of radiation. It's very important to use PET-CT methods, and I would like to show it. Massive lesion of central lung with electasis that is impossible to disconnect. We couldn't differentiate the cancer from electasis, so we contoured. It's the red contour of the cancer. It's 800 cubic centimeters, and we couldn't have even 60 grade dose for the healthy lung. We had PET-CT after that, so we had the focal. According to PET-CT, it's green. It was twice as big, as small as the previous data. So we managed to have 68 grade for this cancerous focal. So PET-CT shows this node. You can see the red. It's the cancerous border, and the cancer itself is smaller. And talking about the efficiency and safety of combined treatment, we need to mention proton therapy. There are several studies on assessment of protons, and two of them are combined, proton therapy plus chemotherapy, and the doses are 74 gray. It's connected with the fact that in proton radiology, the load to healthy tissues is lower. It's 20-25 grades, the borderline for pneumonitis. It's about two times lower than used photon radiation. So we will try to increase the safety and the treatment dose. The results of one of the researches of 2017, it's stage 3 non-small cell lung cancer combined with chemotherapy, 64 patients, good median of observation, dose 74 gray, chemotherapy, carboplatin with paclitaxel. The results of toxicity are very positive. Acute radial pneumonia in one patient, late radial pneumonitis in 16 and 12 patients, no side effect of fifth grade, comparable to photon therapy, but in lower doses, not 74, but about 60 grade. Unfortunately, we cannot talk about this escalation, even in protons, can lead to the efficiency of treatment and survival rate. These data are absent. We need just to wait. Nowadays, there are lots of centers of proton therapy, and they are accumulating material quite fast. Nowadays, we deal with proton therapy for a year and a half, and we have 260 patients who have received their treatment with lung cancer. Only two of them were with lung cancer. Nowadays, it's due to organizational questions, but we hope to increase the amount of such patients, and to my mind, the perspectives of more active combined treatment in our country exist, but we need to meet several requirements. First of all, modern radiotherapy devices using additional diagnostic methods, PET-CT, for example, better qualification of therapeutists, and good follow-up and during treatment and after treatment. And in conclusion, I will move to questions. I've got four questions. The first one, how much are you satisfied with your own experience of combined treatment of NSCLC? Mostly positive, mostly negative, more negative, don't have experience? two people have voted so far. More than two, three and a half, five people. So the experience is more positive, it's good. It means that eventually these patients are selected and accurately treated. Let's move to our next question. We are short of time. What are the obstacles to conduct combined treatment in your institutions absent of radiational therapy? Concerns of chemotherapists about complications, radiotherapeutists' concerns about complications, no obstacles. I use it actively.